Adam, we start with the drama on the dance floor. Season number 19 of Dancing with the Stars comes to a close next week.
Now, the favorite, again, just give him the trophy. No. Here he is, Alfonso Ribeiro. He was able to battle. He had a severe back injury, had some injuries, had all kinds of issues. But he and his partner still got a total score of 75. Two couples danced their way to perfect scores last night, though.
Bethany Mota and a shirtless Derek used a picture frame to affect in their modern dance. And Janelle Parrish and Val were fiery and forceful in their paso doble. Going home, senior stoner Tommy Chong held in much longer.
Senior stoner? Is that what we call him?
That's what we sort of, I hope he's okay with that term. But Chong and his partner were sent packing. That leaves just four couples left for next week's two-part season finale.
We'll turn to Prince William now. He's going to the birds to save endangered animals. He's been campaigning for a while against illegal animal poaching and as an underground activity that threatens rare populations. Now his organization, United for Wildlife, has partnered with Angry Birds to make a special version of that game.
It's called Roll with the Pangolin. And the pangolin, as the prince explains, is an anteater and one of the most endangered animals on the planet because of poaching. The game will be available now through Sunday with all proceeds to benefit the cause.
You do? You do play?
No.
You don't?
I don't even like the Candy Crush thing. Do you know the Candy Crush
thing? What's the Candy Crush?
People are really into it. I had to do a thing for World News once about it, and I wasn't really into it even after doing it.
Okay, we're not into any of this.
But you know what a lot of people are into?
What's that?
Taylor Swift.
No.
Yeah, and last month she got a lot of bad vibes from New Yorkers. Oh. They were critical of her and her new role as tourism ambassador for the city. But she's got one very famous New Yorker coming to her defense.
Yes, the piano man, Billy Joel, doesn't care that Taylor hasn't lived here very long. In an interview with USA Today, Joel says, "You snoots, let her in."
A warm welcome for T Swift and a Bronx cheer for all her haters. You know they're still gonna hate, 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 and the player's just gonna play, play, play.
Well, let's turn to some other players here. Newlyweds now. Right?
Yeah.
Brad and Angelina, they have made their first official appearance as a married couple.
The pair hit the red carpet together Monday evening in Sydney, Australia for the world premiere of Unbroken. Mrs. Pitt dazzled the crowd with a strapless black lace Gucci gown while her husband was looking pretty fly with a cool pair of shades.
Now, the Hollywood power couple, known as Brangelina, been together for 10 years, but in August they finally made it official, if you will, and said, "I do." And there they are, first
they
official adling as a married couple.
Mm-hmm. Well, Chris Pratt is revealing his recent secret to success, and he says he does not want to turn back.
Now, there he is in an interview with GQ. He's on the cover there. Pratt says he lost 60 pounds to get in shape for his big role in this summer's blockbuster Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy.
60 pounds, that's a lot. He looks amazing there. Wow. One of the ways he said he did it was by avoiding alcohol and carbs. Oh, I hate when people tell me about that. Carbs and alcohol, really? And Pratt says he's done with that. He shared his transformation on Instagram. And as we check out that six pack, yep, and those guns, yep, it's easy to see why.
I don't remember him having 60 pounds to lose.
I don't either. I think he's always looked stunning.
60 pounds, that's amazing. Congrats, though, but that'll do it. You get rid of the carbs, get rid of the alcohol. I know the alcohol part's difficult for you.
It is.
But
thanks for that.
To get rid of the carbs. We turn to the celebrity birthdays now.
Well, celebrating their big day today is the star of Wedding Crashers and Midnight in Paris, actor Owen Wilson turns 46.
And from the Friday, next Friday movies, also The Hangover, comedian and actor Michael Epps, he's 44 now.
And actress Chloe here from Boys Don't Cry and Kids Turn. She turns 40. Happy birthday to everyone.
And Big Bobby, he is turning 39. That's David Ortiz of the Boston Red Sox. Happy birthday, everybody.